Recently, YouTube removed one of my videos due to its medical misinformation policy. If you try to click on its link, you're met with this screen. So in this video, I'd just like to set the record straight using data and information publicly available from official and respectable sources. Yesterday, 25th of October 2022, the Royal Australian College of General Practitioners, RACGP, published an article titled "Vaccine and Infection Myocarditis Risks Contrasted." It can be found on Google News. Do not read other news articles on Google, as they may be spreading dangerous misinformation. In the RACGP article, they state, "A new Immunisation Coalition chart illustrates the much higher myocarditis risks following COVID-19 infection compared to vaccination. Clicking on the chart, according to the Immunisation Coalition, we can see the risk of myocarditis per million people by age, gender, and vaccination status, although only two genders have been included, which is not very inclusive. You may wish to pause this video if you'd like to take a more in-depth look. The chart shows us that the risk of myocarditis is much higher post-COVID-19 infection. In terms of the vaccinated cohort, teenage males and males in their 20s were at elevated risk of myocarditis for both Pfizer and Moderna, as well as for teenage females who took two or three doses of the Moderna vaccine. Although the risk of myocarditis post-vaccine is still lower than the risk post-COVID infection, at least according to this chart by the Immunisation Coalition. In the interests of full disclosure, I think it's important we take a look at what the or who the Immunisation Coalition are, as I honestly had never heard of them. On their website, they state that they are an independent, not-for-profit organisation. We collaborate with like-minded organisations such as primary health networks, public health units, government health departments, and other groups that fight vaccine hesitancy. As they are not-for-profit, they must receive funding from somewhere, so on the same page further down, they do address this. They state that they get funding from sponsors, grant givers, and in-kind supporters, and sources of revenue include healthcare and pharmaceutical industries. They list their in-kind supporters, which include Google, and their sponsors and supporters include Moderna and Pfizer. Of course they do. Any surprises there? Anybody?